Cypher poems, you know, bonfire, you know. It's like, you know, this is the world we came from. We had to, like, be the poets when the rappers were blowing up. We would be outside. You know, we weren't slam poets. This is not what we did. We just did poetry and let the slammers kind of hold down Friday night at the New Weekend.
We had Wednesdays.
Yeah, we had Wednesdays and every third Saturday.
Damn right.
And it was back to the corner. All right, yeah. Just, you know, I'm going to do some stuff about my mom. This book right here, if you don't know, again, it won the Author of the Year, New York Book Festival. Yes. And I say that with a lot of pride because I've been finding a new community to be out of, and it's you guys, you know? You know, the New York Latinas Writers Group is some place that I want to be, I want to support forever. It's not just showing up here and doing this kind of stuff. Because I have a lot of women in my life who need writing groups. Yes. Because they don't listen to my edits. They be like, you fucking old qualified, shut up. So this is a piece, this is my favorite moment with my mom. Millie, it's so hot out today because we in Coney Island. Can we go to the aquarium? Woo-hoo. Quicker than I could please, she lets me have it. Ghetto Puerto Rican style. What? ¿Qué tú crees? ¿That I made out of money? My God, yo sé qué problema tu chica. Oh, that's better being pitted because the two of you juntos me veo la super cone en la boca. Yo no te clean a los pelos de los panty mío y $100 de tu sangre. Y no te crees a 20 minutes if you don't like it, que te toco con tu pai because he's a good for nothing blanco desgraciado, poncho. Believe it or not, she's actually in a good mood. My mother Millie is only 5 feet full of tough tenderness. A rare, proudless Puerto Rican by way of a campo called Calle. Rigorous, rebellious, reckless one born second out of 7 children. Chosen to sip the chill chalice of the 1970s tough love supreme. But behind her bold boiling points, she loves me. So unconditional. So I say, okay, Millie, then can we go to the Himalaya ride to dance? See, I knew she would say yes. That's the only thing I like about Coney Island in the summer anyway, is the Himalaya, because the beach is a mess hole of drunk lifeguards getting robbed under the boardwalk. The sand is like walking on hot coal, plus you got broken glass everywhere. So finally, when she couldn't get no more bronze, Millie gets up off her floral house blanket, folds it into a red pleather oversized purse, and we're off to the Himalaya. I love this ride so much. It would spin around in circles really fast in these up and down waves and slow down and go backwards on request. The theme around the ride, all these painted mountains of snow with men skiing down the slopes, but it isn't the ride that people love about the Himalaya. It's the music. There's always a party outside, and the DJ will play all the latest and classic disco joints. So when me and Millie finally get to the Himalaya, it is packed with people from all over the city. We work our way into the flashy crowd, trying our best to stay on everybody's one, when all of a sudden, the DJ plays my mother's favorite record, Ring My Bell. She grabs me by the hand, catches a beat, and we start doing our hustle. I look up and I see Millie staring at me with those baby brown pearls, swaying a silk scarf tightly wrapped around her dark and lovely dyed curls, with layaway jewelry on her prison tattooed arm that she got from the Brenda lady. Tipping a loose grip towards the hook, that's when Millie lets go and gives a 10-year-old man child the solo of his life. This moment of mine, medium rare, so I don't let her down. Every shimmy, every shake, every slide, every glide slides in sync. The crowd tightens their cipher. Black folks look at me crooked eye. Give them my two-step, just get out of town look. It's like no one and nothing else exists but their soul clap in the stained glass river Nile of tears, salty, stinging my mother's smile. I could hear her pitch perfect in the background yelling, "That's my boy."